Texas versus MKLA was going to be a winner's finals on an MSM?
No, I mean, honestly, when I looked at the bracket, that was my personal prediction.
Really?
Yeah, yeah.
You know what? I'll give it to Ike Tyson. He's been saying for the past few weeks, people got to respect Nexus. And today is the day, man.
Yeah.
Today's the day. Win or lose, man, Nexus deserves a lot of respect, man. And he's brought
to Nexus has been killing it, man. I'm like, we live in a timeline where Nexus could be SoCal PR. I'm like, I'm not trolling. Like,
and
he's that good.
And if you're wondering what the four ramen tag is for, it's because he knows Mr. R. He's played with Mr. R. He's trained with him a couple times. Players like Mr. R and Mr. E, he's happened to actually play with before. So Nexus is no stranger to top players altogether. So we'll see, man. The lone Falco representative here on the winner's side, because Larry has been knocked into losers, of course, by MKLeo. You're just catching up.
Yes, in SoCal, we are the land of the species. Not so much Fox in this game, but I don't know, the bird is making quite the appearance. Leo is schmixing right now, though the frame trap's coming out, catching the landing with the dash attack. Oh, almost gets the reverse up B.
Okay, so far, I think that's the one thing we're going to have to see, how MKLeo's adaptability is against Falco.
Bear?
That's a bear.
Oh,
no, he's living.
That was so close.
Town and City, baby. Town and City. You know that blast zone is extra nice to you.
Yeah, and man, Leo was very close to getting edgeguarded there. That's one thing that might be a factor here.
You know, I give it to Nexus because he striked PS2, and then Leo strike, if I'm not mistaken, he strike Final Destination.
Oh my god.
So he went to Town and City, which is the closest thing we can get. And this is good. Oh no, this is rough. This
reverse
is rough.
Reverse Nair? Okay, Leo. Yeah, okay, Leo!
Back with that forward air to stop Nexus all the way, even from the side B. Man, what a play.
God damn! The backside edge guard into the drop zone fair. Okay. Nexus answering back though.
I like it. Get the illusion back on the stage. But look at that patience at the right side of the stage too. He's very cautious about how MKLeo can trap him as he tries to get back towards center stage. Okay, he's living. Save that jump.
Ooh, the juggles. This is rough. Oh my god, another up air. No, goes for the up B. I like that. Leo utilizing that range on the up B there. Forward throw, back air tipper does not connect, but that would have probably been death.
Oh, what a reaction out of the shield. And that's a nice little combo up tilt. Not going to be any confirm afterwards. MKLeo is going to fall out. Up air, yeah, it's a nice play. Like I said, those blast zones are so grateful to everybody who picks the stage.
Nexus maybe not believing in that up tilt. The bear came a little late. Or maybe Leo just a tad bit out of that percentage range, 118%. Trying to get the catch with the up smash. Tech chase. Okay, get up attack is going to thwart that.
Oh, no reflector coming out here for Nexus. Left side of the stage. He's got to watch out for that play. Comes in with illusion. What a great tech chase from that Nair to dash attack.
Nair, okay, going to catch the spot dodge there. Another little laser there, tacking on some damage. But at this point, yeah.
I did like that laser, though, because he wants MKLeo to hold shield right, give him some space to land. But the problem is, like, that's what Byleth still is, regardless whether you like it or not. She still is, he or she is still the distance demon.
Right,
so
right.
Anywhere where Nexus was looking to land from that distance, MKLeo could just control that altogether.
Yeah, absolutely. And at that point, Leo was ledge trapping and pointing the yellow stick at the bad guy there, the up tilt and then the forward tilt coming out. Had so much rage, you know, so much percentage there. Just really just reacting there and getting the stock. We'll see if Nexus can get something started here on, I believe, another round at Town and City. I feel like Town is a pretty nice stage for Falco, just in the sense where if you get an up tilt right at the edge, the blast zones from the edge of the stage horizontally are really, you know, short, so up tilt back air would be very nice. Oh, the forward smash coming out. Leo making no exceptions here. The Nair tech chases are continuing. Not going into tumble, but the spacing.
I do like that from Nexus. Oh, able to get the illusion. Soft spike, but MKLeo with a hard spike. Sensing that ledge play from there, and then immediately able to take the stock lead. And Nexus looking to respond in kind. He is taking this man off the stage.
Yeah, a lot of times Nexus is going for these edge guards where he's re-grabbing the ledge, so Leo's able to get a punish with something like down air.
Yeah.
It's pretty risky. I mean, going for the one runoff is fine, but it's just so risky if you miss, because the tether just retracts back to the ledge so quick. Leo is able to get a reset, and that tether is the best tether in the game as well in terms of range, so it can be pretty hard to drop down and get Leo here.
Yeah, good for Nexus to use the Nair, able to stop the starting frames on that side B, and the Falco Fire able to still recover. I think Nexus needs to do a really good job here at the edge guard. Spot dodge, but no Nair, and I like that drift back too, because he knows how MKLeo is going to go for that roll to recover. Oh no.
He had to hit the hard angle there. In those kind of situations, like, you only mix if you have to, but just going to pick it back up with the slight charge on the up smash, going to take Leo right off the top here. Leo trying to go for a full hop Nair, because that is how you can get those Nair chains. Very similar to Politana, but a little harder since you have to full hop it.
Yeah, and I do like that even though he doesn't get the reflector at the end, he's looking to push MKLeo more to the side to get more stage control. But not only that, but just put in more damage. But MKLeo, that's the hard part about the being in the land of the Spaceys, that recovery plan is so linear, you're used to it. You know how to recover. If you know how Fox recovers, you know how Fox recovers at the same time. So MKLeo knows what he can do to this character when it comes to the recoveries.
Leo opting for the downside. There's the up tilt. Center DI for Leo. Does not want it. Wants to just be in the center of the stage, but the back air does not matter. That move is so damn strong.
Look, if I'm Nexus Man, even if it's 1-1 apiece, you're looking for at least one game, and he starts off nice with an illusion. No confirm there, but I do like how he's a little bit patient looking to see how MKLeo is going to respond. And climb fair from the ledge, catching MKLeo pressing a button here, and he's looking to just hold center stage control. I like this play from Nexus because he knows what it's all about being in that high percent.
Yeah, I think at this point, Nexus can slow it down, maybe not even go too crazy on these edgeguards.
Oh no, not like that. No.
Dang, that. Okay, so again, Nexus had to hit the ledge. He probably wanted to go to ledge and get that slight angle. Those angles are a little harder to hit, but again, Nexus kind of putting himself in the position where he's forcing himself to get these hard angles. Leo is making it very clear that he's not going for any crazy drop zone dares or nairs, right? Leo is definitely a ledge trapper,
yeah,
especially with Byleth.
He's able to have the distance at the ledge, too, while also being closer to the center stage. So Nexus has to be extra cautious how his recovery. Had it been any other character with less range, and Nexus might have been fine. But the thing here is that you have to always respect Byleth's range altogether. But this is going to be a different start here for MKLeo. Up throw, up air, and Nexus already taking a lot of percent. I like that tech roll. Very cautious where he's going to land.
Yeah, absolutely. Leo just paying absolute respect to the illusion on that last stock and was able to get the Firebird. But nonetheless, we are on to the next game. Nexus, I like that kind of edgeguard where going for like a dare back on a stage, something that covers a little higher and then opts for the ledge trap here. But the backer setting up after the up B. Leo now with the ledge trap.
Yeah, like that from Nexus. A little bit of patience. I'll wait for MKLeo to make the first move. Able to jump around, forward air to respond and keep him off the stage.
Ooh, okay.
A couple lasers for good measure to keep him off the deep end. But man, that down tilt, you have to respect that range because it will confirm into an up air at those percents. And it will take you for a round of trip to the skies, unfortunately.
And Nexus has some rage there. Instead of going for grab. Oh, that's enough.
That is enough.
Okay.
All right, Nexus with a stock lead here. Okay, able to get this back air. Neutral air to get him out of the shield there too. Knows how MKLeo wants to get out of the ledge.
Oh man, the corner, the nair barely connecting on that very last hit. Okay, jab instead of up B there, or maybe up. I'm not too sure how fast the up smash is on Byleth. Probably enough to get illusion, but nonetheless, this is going to be a regrab.
Oh, this is good for Nexus. Okay, 3-1 against MKLeo, game three. Nexus still has a lot of fight in him, and he has a lot to prove tonight.
Oh yeah, exactly. I mean, these drop zone edge guards are finally coming together. Gets the weak down air there. Uh-oh, wait a minute. Is this a
That's the easy down air. I still commend Nexus because he still goes for something like the reflector and the projectile to stop MKLeo from his game plan.
Right.
But unfortunately, you are in the recovery, and then you will get hit by that down air.
Doesn't go for a drag down. Falco can go for a drag down there into another down tilt rep. Or maybe Nexus just keeping it simple here. But nonetheless, Leo starting things up with the throw into. Oh, charging it. Oh my goodness.
That was scary. Yeah,
He read him. Yeah. He read him. It's just a little bit off. But Leo kind of using that charge, making you think that, oh, you're going to angle it down. Get me on the ledge there. Okay, there's the drag down into the grab. Down air. Where are we going?
Oh, into the forward air. Trying to push him off the stage. Nexus looking for this big play. Immediately to put a point on the board. I like that. He's both players a little bit in the neutral, looking at who holds center stage. MKLeo knows it's big to make that comeback. Get him off the stage here. MKLeo is looking for a possible nice, because he knows that illusion is going to be an option, and then punishing with forward or back air, depending on what side he lands, is really good.
Yeah, and it looks like Byleth Nair is not quick enough to get this illusion. Maybe Nexus opting for the aerial version.
He burned the jump too, but yeah.
Uh-oh.
That's rough, too, because at that point, Nexus might have – he was kind of pressured to go for an option like that, seeing as how the dental can confirm for those options.
Oh, here's the – okay, bear does not connect. The trade into the bear.
Is that it? That is it. Nexus with one game over MKLeo, ladies and gentlemen.
All right. Nexus being able to tell the rest of SoCal, I took a game off MKLeo.
Did Larry do it? I know he's going to say it. I know he's going to say it.
Not a lot of people in SoCal could say that. Not a lot of people on the planet can say that, actually.
Yeah, not a lot of
But nonetheless, I know Nexus isn't just looking for a game. He wants the set. And, I mean, this is going to be the place to prove it here.
Yeah, this is big for Nexus. A lot of SoCal history with this player. You know, one of the – coming from the Valley area of SoCal, if you will, the more Hollywood Studio City area of Southern California, if you will. And on top of that, he's kind of known as one of the great busters, like, way back in the day. And to see him come into full form here, at least a point on the board over MKLeo when Larry could not do it, man, that's big enough for him, and especially here at MSM. 241.
I guess that means Nexus is the best Falco in SoCal, huh?
Oh, man. War Chief
just nodded ahead of approval there. It is official. The best Falco in Southern California.
Oh, man. If I were Mr. R, man, I'd be popping off when you're rewatching this VOD, man. All right. Well, Nexus looking to get some. Hopefully, looking to pop off, at least get that game five going here. But MKLeo has a lot to do about it here. Dash attack to put Nexus off the stage, stopping him from the forward air. That's one of the Nexus' favorite options from the ledge.
Okay, wait a minute. Oh, the side beat.
Oh, no.
Damn.
That
was... Wow. He just side beat from the forward smash. Damn.
Nexus tried to immediately catch that side beat afterwards with a grab, and I commend him for that, but that range in where Violet's side beat leaves them safe is really good. Oh, great tech from Nexus. Definitely sensing out that option.
Okay, Nexus taking quite a bit of damage on the second stock. That the up air, is it enough? Okay, it doesn't get crossed up on the DI. The air dodge gets caught, but Leo does not get the dash tech where he needs it. Okay, the tech chase.
Oh, what a read! So Leo wanted a tech. You would normally want a tech roll in towards the stage, but Nexus with a really good read, understanding. Okay, he's at the corner. Finish him off here, and let me at least get this two stock difference between my first stock.
Dang, triple up air, Violet coming through. There's the grab into the fair. Wow, already two interactions, 61% for MKLeo. Gets the ledge jump.
Oh, he's been jumping from the ledge too.
And he's like really understanding the timing. Oh, and the double jump with the up air as well. Can't catch my re-grab. The side B to anti-air. What is happening right now? The up air to end it off. Yes, Leo coming through, and I guess I'll say it. Yeah, game four, Leo. A lot of you guys know the deal.
Yeah, you all heard it this past weekend. Yeah, game four, Leo. We know.